What's good, y'all? Welcome to HRL Heavy Rotation Live on Mix. We're live right now on Mix Global on Twitch and Kumu. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Make sure you follow us and subscribe. DJ Marlino here, and tonight's show is going to be all vibes. My special guest is a good friend to the show. She's a Filipino-American R&B singer, songwriter, vocal coach, and entrepreneur, and she emerged in 2016 with her EP Voices and a few other collabs. Earlier this year, she spearheaded the Alone Together album, which featured 40 independent artists from all around the world, all produced from the comfort of their homes. And last month, she dropped a brand new EP titled My Ghost Pet Monster, and she's here to perform it for you live. This is Jessica Louise from Los Angeles, California, on Heavy Rotation Live.
Cause there ain't nobody else in my imagination holding a conversation. I don't really just make a deal. What do you need to think or feel? We could have or say goodbye. But first, can you forgive me?
Too late for you and I to celebrate. P.S. You could slide in the left or right. Trust the time while I do the rest. It's never too late for you and I to celebrate. Dancing in outer space. All fine. While I do the rest. It's never too late for you.
Mixology. Jessica Louise on Heavy Rotation Live. Albert Posis on Mixclusives. Red Matic on Mixology. Cameron Calloway on Heavy Rotation Live. Clinton Kane on Mixclusives. Fresh artists and music first from around the world.
Follow and subscribe to Watch Daily.
Thank you guys for tuning in to HRL. You know what it is. Family is in the house. Jessica Louise.
Hello.
How are you? It's been, I want to say like a little over a month since we last talked and since we were on Kumu again. And last time you had dropped the All Together at Home album. And then now you have this brand new EP. We just heard a few of the songs off the EP. It's called My Ghost Pet Monster. So let's talk about that a little bit. But I want to find out, like, what's been going on with you since the month? Like, what have you been working on and doing?
Oh my gosh, so much. Well, first off, it's great to see you. It's great to be on here again. And I guess it's just, yeah, I've been working on just a ton of new music. You know, it's been, we're all quarantined still. And I don't know, music to me has always been, it's like for healing processes. So I think because of everything that's going on, the only thing I really can do is just make more music. So I've been actually writing even more for another new project, but I won't talk too much about that because it's still in the very early phases.
Nice.
But definitely have been writing a lot more. I launched a school, an online school, and where I teach people how to sing and how to release music themselves as an independent artist, and we're like expanding that. So there's quite a bit that's been going on.
Yes, there is.
So that's, you know, like the gist of it,
no. You know how it is. Like, to me, I always call you a quadfecta, right? Because you're not only a singer, you're a songwriter, you're an entrepreneur, you're a vocal coach. I mean, like, you're the whole package. You can pretty much do everything. And so I admire that about you because you have such grit and passion and grind in you. And it's exciting when you put out new projects. So let's jump into the new one, My Ghost Pet Monster. So my first question is, I haven't talked to you since you released this. How did you come up with the name for this? Why did you pick My Ghost Pet Monster?
I know, it's such a strange name. I actually kept going for the career and then ultimately was like, well, it has so much meaning for me. Mm-hmm. So actually, I want to say like 2 years ago, now it was a while ago, I invited a poet friend of mine over to my house and was just like, I just wanted to write poetry, which I do very quietly, like very quietly. I just have hundreds of poems. And so he came over and I just was having a really bad, I had a really bad panic attack the night before, which is something I've been a lot more vocal about as of recently, especially in the world, is, you know, like mental health and really just inspiring open communication about it. Like it's not like a scary bad thing. So this was 2 years ago, I had a really bad panic attack. And my friend says, I want you to write a poem where you personify your anxiety. And I was like, okay. And And I wrote this super long, painfully beautiful poem. And at the end of it, I said, I love you, my ghost pet monster. And so the name of the EP actually is a symbol of whatever in the way that stops you from really just going after all of your dreams and doing what it is that you want to do. And it was just so bizarre. I don't know why I said this phrase. And then I was like, that's weird. And I was like, oh, it's like a ghost. So it's always, you know, for me, it was like anxiety or just like just being like in integrity with my overall well-being and my mental health. So the ghost part is like, you know, this thing is kind of like lurking in the background all the time, but it's a pet because if you take care of yourself and, you know, you surround yourself by amazing people, you really like you eat well, all that. And then it's a pet. You can like maintain it. The monster is like, you know, if you don't maintain it, it really has the power to just take everything you've done and like destroy it. And so that's the name. I don't know. I was just, you know what? That's it. That's the name.
That's crazy. I mean, that's so deep, to be honest with you. I mean, like, I don't even know what to say. I'm kind of speechless because I'm like, wow, that's very thought provoking and how you articulated that. So, wow, that's crazy. All right. So Mamie, tell me, why is this EP important to you right now? You know, you've had Voices, you've had, oh my gosh, I forgot the other one. Living was the other one.
In Fiction. Yeah, Living in Fiction.
Living in Fiction. And then so now this one. So why is this EP important to you right now?
This is important to me. One, because of the sound. So you'll notice it's much more pop oriented, like pop R&B, which is a bit different from what I had been doing before. So it's sort of like this evolve, like Jessica evolved, and I really love it. This is definitely, I feel like I finally found my home. I'm like, yes. And so that's one, is the sonics of it. And two, it really is, it's like it's a statement and a symbol of me being vulnerable and authentic as an artist.
Yeah.
Before, I really would just figure out a lot of things like, oh, maybe people will like this, or like, do I like this? And I was just caught up in a lot of thoughts. Mm-hmm. And this EP is like, I don't care, actually. Like, this is me. Here's my heart on my sleeve. If you love it, great. If you don't, also great. Like, it almost, yeah, I guess it's me stepping into me as an artist, regardless of what is super popular or not. Yeah. And yeah, that's why this is a big one for me.
I mean, considering like what you just said, like, if you like it or you don't like it, you weren't kind of creating it for everyone else. But I tell you, the EP is such a mood, like just listening to all the songs. I mean, you put it together really well. So, I got to commend you on that. Like, there's a few songs I love off there, and I'll ask you about that in a minute. But I'm curious to find out, like, what was the most memorable part in creating this EP?
The most memorable part of creating the EP, honestly,
You can't say getting it done.
Oh, I was going to say, actually, like, I know this is so silly because it's like everywhere and it's a really big deal, but like making the GPS music video was like such a big accomplishment for me, because I always wanted to put my family in a project of mine and it just never felt right. And so I think, and then even writing GPS, you know, GPS is actually inspired by the loss of a loved one.
Oh,
so
wow.
It's like, it's super fun. Actually, this is like, all the songs are super fun pop songs, but lyrically they're kind of like a little bit sad. Like GPS, like, I'm lost, impatient, where do I go? My brain is spinning out of control, wasting days, lost in a haze. Like, where do I go now? You know, like, this person has passed away. I don't know. Could you be my GPS? You just tell me where to go because I'm lost. And clearly you know something more than I do. So I think it was definitely the GPS music video was such a phenomenal experience, even though we were completely remote. Yeah. And then this making the song GPS was also really special. I wrote the song and produced it with Jesse Parra and Tim Atlas, who are also Filipino. It's just so funny how that happened.
Yeah, that's crazy. And yeah, it worked out really well.
Yeah.
So I was going to ask you, like you said, your family members were in. So was that like your cousins, brother, mom, dad, like everyone, like your whole entire family was in there?
Like a lot of my extended family was on. My mom and dad were in it. My little brother was not. This is a butthead. Sorry, Jason, calling me out. but my mom and dad are on there. My nieces and nephews are on there. My uncles and my aunts. It was a whole family affair. And then we put out a call to anybody. And I remember saying this on the One Down Instagram as well as mine. Like, anybody wants to be in this video, submit just like you dancing to it. We'll put it in.
Yeah.
And so it's like my family plus our my now extended family. I feel like anybody who was in that music video is now part of my extended family. So it was really like we did such a good job of bringing people together without bringing people together. Like, if that makes sense.
No, so shout out to One Down. I did an awesome job in putting that video together. Also, Kumu sponsored that video as well. Yes. So big up to everyone on Kumu. And since you're here, I know you have your phone right next to you. So go ahead and we can shout out some people. If you see anyone in the chat right now showing you some love, I see some people dropping Holo Holo and Carlito Holo. So go ahead and feel free to say hi to anyone on there.
This is so awesome. Thank you, D Realistic. Thank you. XS Leanne, what's up? Hi, Alyssa LeCue. Up, guys! Thank you for being here, and thanks for the love. I love Kumu. I still haven't figured it out. It's still really confusing to me. But
so, I was telling you, you and I, we're gonna hang out on Kumu. We'll just do like a chill night, just hang out. It'll be like we're at a casino. That's what I tell people. It's like a casino when you're on here.
That's cool, Pino.
So I want to ask you, what is your favorite song off the EP?
Oh, my favorite song off the EP is Still Learning to Love Myself.
That's such a bop too.
Yeah, and it's like, I know that it's not like huge fan favorite, but it's like a love song to myself. And because of that, I'm totally biased. And that's definitely my favorite song on there. My favorite song to perform, I didn't do it today, but my favorite song to perform is Back to You. It's
like, I knew you were going to say that too, and I was hoping that that was a song that you were going to perform tonight also. But that is honestly my favorite song off this EP. Like, I've been playing it on heavy rotation, and my surprise to you that I was telling you off the air is that song became number 2 on heavy rotation's top 10 countdown. So people were requesting it over the weekend, and yeah, just blew you to number 2. So not only did you debut on the countdown, but your song came in at number 2. So yeah, big ups. Don't cry. You're not supposed to cry on our show.
That's amazing. Oh my gosh. Thank you. Thank you to all the listeners. It's weird. I'm like, I'm just shocked. Like, that is so, so incredible. And thank you. I'm glad you like it. I feel like it's kind of like Mariah vibes a little bit.
It kind of does, but I think like the message behind it, because remember we were just talking about that. I was going to ask you, is that song about someone in particular? And so go ahead and tell us the backstory behind this song.
Yeah. So actually this is Back to You is the only song on the EP that's not written about a specific person. But I remember I wrote it a while ago. I went to Tim Atlas's house for the first time. We had a writing session. It's just like, random. It was like, hey, I want to write a new song for the album. We were just like, let's just write something. And he just started playing chords. And we wrote the song in like an hour or two. And then I tried to track the vocals another time to hit like these really big notes. I don't know. I think I was feeling it when I was recording the demo. And fun fact, I haven't told anybody this, is a lot of the vocals on the song are actually the scratch demo vocals from that exact day, from the writing session day. And I was like, these are good. Like, I keep trying to recreate that moment, but I don't know. I guess I was just feeling it. So yeah, that song isn't about a particular person. I think that I probably was in a mood because I was like, is anyone going to notice me? Like, I don't know where that lyric came from. Like, I wrote this song, so maybe you might finally notice me. So I was probably like, like in some kind of mood. But yeah, I think, I don't think I've ever shared with you my writing process, but what I probably did was just mumble a couple of words. And then I just put them together. Like, it just sort of fit. Oh, if you only knew, I'd be so. Yeah, that's probably okay, what happened.
Can you rock a quick acapella of it?
Yes.
Just for the sake of everyone, to so they can hear the song.
Heck yeah. So it goes like this. Oh, if you only knew, I'd be so good to you. If only you let me show you what you're missing, babe. You pick the time and place, I'll be right on my way. No matter what I do, I always come back to you.
Woo! See, that is my joint. That is my favorite song off your EP.
Yay! That seems to be the favorite as of now. Actually, that and surprisingly Catalog Boy. A lot of you guys are saving that song on Spotify, which is like, I asked a bunch of people, like, which one's your favorite, like, before I released, just to do some research. Nobody picked Catalog Boy except for my mom. My mom's like, that's the best song. I was like, seriously? And she's like, see, I told you people were gonna like Catalog Boy.
Yeah, that one, and yeah, back to you. I've seen so many comments from people saying how much they love that song. So that's dope, man. So I wanted to ask you, because we were talking about this too, because like, you have so much stuff on your plate, right? So you have the school, you've put out this new EP, you're working on another EP, and on your IG, you had mentioned something about you weren't going to do something, but you said, screw it, I'm going to do it. I can't remember what you had posted. I was trying to look for it right now as we're talking. I can't remember the whole quote that you had you posted something. Anyways, what I was going to tell you was, the one thing I admire about you is that you're constantly challenging yourself. And so, like, I remember, like, literally, like, a month and a half ago, you were trying to reach these Mariah riff high note things. And then, you know, you're like, crap, I can't do it. I'm going to do it again. And you just kept being resilient about it and just kept being persistent and doing it and doing it. And then so when I saw what you had posted today, that's kind of what I guess that's what reminded me of your character. I was going to say that, like, yeah, you know, you may feel afraid to do it, but I know you. You're going to do it anyways, and you're going to take that risk, and you're going to try it. And I think that's what's so remarkable about you, is that you're constantly growing. You're constantly trying to improve. So the question here, and where I'm getting to, is
yeah.
How do you stay, I guess, focused on doing that?
Yeah, wow. Well, first, thank you.
It's okay. You'll get me seasick nachos when this whole thing is over anyway, so.
Is that a thing? Seasick nachos?
Girl, we're going to hook you up. We'll get you hooked up. Yes.
I haven't had seasick in forever. I don't know if you know this. I actually stopped eating meat. I'm waiting for...
That's what I figured, but we're going to have to take a break on that just for the seasick.
Yeah, so. For one thing. You know what? It's possible. And thank you for that acknowledgement. And also, you know, how do I stay focused? Man, I think I've just spent a lot of time inward, like really meditating and getting really clear on the difference that I want to make in the world. This is so cheesy, but... it's so clear for me. It's like I see so many people who really have this desire to either sing or just express themselves. And if I can be the symbol of, like, you know, for someone to then take an action that would lead them to expressing themselves, then I win. So I don't know. I just every morning I think about that. I think about my goals. I have a giant poster of a Grammy in my room. And like, I'm going to say it here, actually, I'm playing a game called Grammy 2023. And it's almost like because of that, I'm like, well, yeah, I'm going to get up. I have it on my calendar to write 100 songs by the end of this year. Actually doing pretty well. But I think it's like, I'm so clear on the difference that I want to make and my goals. And I am present to them every day, not like, I have to hit my goal, like I'm like a workhorse, but just like, no, this is what I want to do with my life. And whether it takes 3 years or whether it takes 10 years, you know, it's just like, I'm just going to keep showing up because that's what I know to do. And that's what I know is going to make the biggest difference. So.
And I think that's the biggest nugget for everyone to take away is what you just said, keep showing up. Because I think like what you just described. You described your vision, but I think what is exciting for me, even as a spectator, is watching this journey on you getting there. I think that's going to be the most fun, right?
Yeah.
Because documenting it, seeing what comes out of it. You know, your goal may be 100, but who knows? You might end up writing 150, or even if you come short, but then let's say it's like 75, but those 75 are just like classics.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that's what I'm excited for. I'm excited to see what happens within this next year and a half to see you get to 2023. And, you know, get that Grammy, girl. Do it.
Let's go. Let's get it. I'm so stoked. Like, I can't sleep at night sometimes because I'm like, well, that's it. That's what I'm going to do. And I think once you do like that inner work stuff, the outer stuff just sort of naturally flows. I mean, but you know, I've been at this for a long time.
Yeah.
Or not a long time, but in the scope of music. Because they say in music, it takes like 10 years.
Yeah.
From like when you start to like you actually getting your big break, which is ridiculous.
I've heard that from so many artists. It's the same
thing.
Yeah.
And if I, you know, in perspective, I'm like, oh, great. Because I've been doing it for 5 years now. It's at the halfway point. And it's just, yeah, it's cool. And it's great to document the journey. And then being like looking back and being like, oh, cringy.
So you gotta make a promise to me. So every time you feel discouraged and you feel like things aren't happening, I want you to remember this conversation that we had and say, this is all part of the journey. I'm going to get there. So I want you to remind yourself that every single time.
Okay. I promise.
Cool. Okay. And I don't want to keep you too long, 'cause I know you're tired. We've kind of exhausted you a lot. So, let's talk about really quickly, what's coming up next for Jessica? What are you working on?
So I am working on, I'm going to say this here. I am working on my first full length album.
Woo!
I am like alive. I'm so excited. I just upgraded some of my gear, which cost me an arm and a leg. But my next venture is actually to practice production. I produced Earl Grey, but like that's like guitar and vocals. It's easy. But you know, on the album, I want to produce at least 3 songs out of all of them.
So you're talking about full mixing, production, mastering, everything.
Well, I probably wouldn't master it. I might mix it myself, but for sure I want to be the sole producer for at least 3 of the records, 3 of the songs on the record.
Yeah.
I'm working with a couple new producers. I'm super, super excited. And I'm actually still looking for more. The journey to that, it looks like me just playing with a bunch of different people and sort of vibing out and seeing which is a good fit. But that is what's next. And my goal is to have that out by next year, but I probably will be releasing a single like in October. So you guys can keep an eye out. If all goes well, it'll be out in October, the first single.
That's awesome. Jessica is in the house, man. I'm excited for that. I can't wait. When do you think projected date is for the album? You think
For the album, not till like May.
Okay. So we still got a little bit of time. So like sometime next year. And
then
knowing you, there's going to be a couple singles coming out. So I know you, you're going to drop some secret little flavors in between. So excited for that. Go ahead and shout out some people before we let you go.
Oh, shout out mom and dad. I love you. And also shout out the One Down team. I love you guys. Shout out Kumu. Thank you, Kumu, for sponsoring GPS. And that's it. Shout out to just to my cousins, my badass cousins who I miss so much because I haven't seen any of my family in a long time.
That's awesome. Let's go ahead and do some shouts out on Twitch and on Kumu. So Twitch, go ahead and put in the comments if you're watching, I'll shout you out. And then Jess, go ahead and shout out some folks on Kumu. And if you guys love what you guys heard from Jess tonight, drop some love, give her some holo holo. We have what is in here? There's so many new gifts in here now. I was tripping out on all the new stuff. Like the Wen in Manila, there's a 30. You know, if you're feeling generous, the Yamashita gold is good too. So, you know, hook up Jess, show her some love. on Kumu, you guys.
Let's see. Thank you for the pilot.
And then we got FlipMate23 on Twitch saying hello. So shout out to FlipMate23. I would drop you some coin too, but I ran out of coin. I got
to
reload.
Oh, it's all good. Shout out to Maria Mary 30, Jet Pilot, Trixie. Thank you guys, Tip Guy. Thank you so much. Oh, thank you. Shout out to you guys watching on Kumu.
Shout out to Timmy Sky. She's one of the popular DJs here on Kumu. Also to Jeffrey Monday for sharing this feed, and to Anna 819. I think you mentioned her already. So shout out to all of them. And Jess is on Kumu, you guys. So look her up. It's Jessica Louise Music. She's on Kumu. We're gonna do a little hangout. Like I said, it's gonna be like Kumu Casino or something like that. We'll just hang out and chill, play music. Just, you know, do what we do. Because like I said, you and I can talk forever. Like if we sit here right now, we could probably talk for the next 2 hours. So I want to get you some sleep. But Jess, thank you again. Thank you for the performance. Thank you for hanging out and sharing us the stories behind My Ghost Pet Monster. So guys, get the EP, download it, buy it. Make sure you guys buy it, save it, add it to your playlist. It's all on every single music platform that's out there. So wherever you get your music, look up Jessica Louise and get this EP. Trust me, it's such a vibe. You have to get it. So last thing, go ahead and tell everyone where they can find you if they've never met you before.
All right. Thank you. You can find me at Jessica Louise Music on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. Just type in Jessica Louise Music. Oh, my name is here.
Yep, right down there.
There. That's me. And I just put out a new YouTube video today. I'm putting out more YouTube videos, finally.
And that's what we're going to do. So to take us out of here, I have the new cover that you did. And so I want to show everyone the new. So Jess, go ahead and introduce it to everyone, and then I will talk to you again soon.
Thank you. This next song is a cover I just put out. It's a cover of The Weeknd by SZA, filmed here in my home studio.
And it's right here on Heavy Rotation Live. Say bye to Jess, everyone.
Bye.
You say you got a girl. I want me when you got a girl. The feeling is reckless. I'm knowing I'm selfish, yeah. Knowing I'm desperate. Getting on it in love, falling on over love. Ain't doing to last. Hanging out the bag all over your lap. Like, is you coming home? Is you out with her? I don't care as long as you care. By 10:30, no later than. Drop them drawers, give me what I want. My man is your man, her, that's her man too. My man is your man, her, that's her man. Tuesday and Wednesday, Thursday and Friday, I just keep him satisfied through the weekend. You like 9 to 5 on the weekend. Oh, make him lose his mind every weekend. You take Wednesday, Thursday, then just send it my way. Think I got it covered for the weekend. I gotta sing in the mood for a little bit more than. I mean, I'm saying what kind of deal is 2 days? I need me at least about 4 of them. More than, more you, more me, more us. Just tell me you want me, yeah, one day. And I'll be at your door, ready to take your place. Ready to give you what you've been missing on weekdays. What you've been praying for at 10:30, no later than. Drop them drugs, give me what I want. My man is my man, is your man her, that's her man too. My man is my man, is your man her, that's her man. Tuesday and Wednesday, Thursday and Friday, I just keep him satisfied through the weekend. You like 9 to 5 on the weekend, make him lose his mind every weekend. You take Wednesday, Thursday, then just send him my way. Think I got it covered for